Last week, Nintendo dropped a couple pieces of news completely out of the blue. To begin with, we got a release date for Super Mario 3D World plus Bowser's Fury, including an actual gameplay reveal of how Bowser's Fury plays. We got the announcement of a new Red and Blue Mario Edition Switch, which, assuming I'm able to get my hands on one, I am planning to unbox, so make sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on that. And at the end of the week, we finally got some new gameplay and a release date for the new Pokemon Snap for Switch. Now, these announcements on their own are great, but something that I've been noticing a lot of people kind of use them as a launchpad for is this kind of ongoing worry, debate, or just straight up missing of Nintendo Directs. This has actually been one of the kind of weirder things for me that a lot of people have latched onto in terms of something that Nintendo has not been doing over the last year. Yes, we have had some in a fashion, but not really in the way that a lot of people have been wanting them to be. In fact, the last time we got a true, just simple Nintendo Direct without any kind of additional specification whatsoever was September of 2019, almost a year and a half ago. Since then, through all of 2020, we got a grand total of 9 different Nintendo Directs, but none of them were really catch-all first-party focused ones. We got 4 different mini showcases that were focused on third-party companies just announcing games that would be released on the Switch. We got a couple of very game-specific ones done, like for Monster Hunter, the Mario 35th Anniversary, and even Animal Crossing at the very start of the year. And they did close out last year with a slightly more different one that focused on reveals for the Nintendo theme park. Well, these have all given us little bits of news here and there. They don't exactly live up to the kind of Nintendo Directs we were seeing back to back in 2018 and 2019. That's the kind of vibe that people really want to see return. And it's not something that I think we are going to see again, at least not to the extent that we used to. I don't think Nintendo Directs are completely dead and gone, but I don't think it's going to be the kind of thing where every 3 months we get some kind of big back-to-back series of large announcements. It's really going to be something I think that's reserved much more for either very specific situations like we saw over 2020, and as far as a more traditional one goes, I really don't think we're going to see things like that except maybe during the kind of more traditional big news announcement seasons like, say, E3. Although E3 itself is probably dead now and everyone's doing their own thing there too, but the point I'm trying to make here is that Nintendo Directs are going to be a slightly more reserved thing rather than being a constant like they once were. And a large reason for that is COVID, and really just 2020 in general. Nintendo didn't stop doing Directs simply because they decided they weren't cool anymore. It was clearly a reaction and result of what was happening in terms of when things could be released, thanks to the hit that production was taking due to all the kind of, well, adjustments everyone needed to make. I think one of the clearest signs of this is the fact that when you look at first party announcements for Nintendo, this is something they've really just mostly reserved to being very shortly before the actual release of something. For instance, throughout all of 2020, one of the biggest rumors that people were constantly talking about was, what is Nintendo going to do for the Mario 35th anniversary? There's going to be some kind of big announcement with all this kind of stuff happen, which we did get in a dedicated Nintendo Direct that happened in September, with the release of the game happening in November. 2 months between when the announcement of those games and the release happened. The same thing even applied for, say, Paper Mario, a game that got a standalone announcement out of the blue in May and saw the release of the game happen in the following July. Nintendo is clearly going out of their way to not really announce games that don't have a very close, near, and confirmed release date. The two biggest exceptions to that, as far as games that were announced kind of with a large open window and now have specific dates, are the games we got release dates for last week. Specifically, Super Mario 3D World did get announced during their 35th anniversary Direct, but you could argue that back then, they still had a pretty good idea of when the game would release, and in fact, maybe it was even still near completion, but was mostly being delayed because they didn't want to have it crowded together with other Mario releases like the 3D All-Stars collection. And the new Pokemon Snap did get announced last year, but it was announced during the Pokemon Direct that happened in February, right before all the COVID restrictions and things really kind of got to their peak, and we really started to see that, oh yeah, development things are going to start taking hits. It really is starting at March of 2020 where you see Nintendo not really announcing new stuff. There were some games announced that definitely had larger windows in mind, like say Monster Hunter Rise and Monster Hunter Stories 2, but these are third-party endeavors, not necessarily something that Nintendo is making in-house and has a full control over that development window. Nintendo is not doing Nintendo Directs right now and haven't done a real one in the last year, not because they simply think they aren't cool anymore, but because of the fact that, well, the news and development cycle of everything is in a constant state of flux. And until we're at a point where things feel like they have a consistently better time-framed way of knowing when things are releasing, I really think they are instead going to be focusing on this approach of just simply dropping announcements whenever it makes sense, as far as just, oh, this game's going to come out in 2 months, let's go ahead and announce that right now so everyone knows, build a pipe for it, and then move on to the next thing after that. I don't think Nintendo Directs are necessarily a thing that Nintendo has to do, by the way. Clearly, doing these individual announcements, while it does result in sometimes people complaining that they aren't getting any kind of major back-to-back hype reveal, are still getting these games good sales numbers and still keeping people interested. But again, it is clearly something that people like to see, something that people want to see, and I think that is something that Nintendo will, to some extent, want to try and meet that expectation. It's just instead of being something that happens every 2 to 3 months, it's something that's spaced out much more periodically, either by having these much more third-party focused side ones, or by having a more traditional proper one as a sort of one major event rather than something that's happening consistently throughout the year. This also plays into, again, I think this narrative of what's going on with Nintendo during 2021, because we've talked about this a little bit in the past couple of videos about how right now the release window is pretty bare. Last week gave us 2 games with solid release dates for 2021, which is nice, but aside from all the numerous third-party games we know coming, as far as first-party Nintendo stuff goes, the list is very light right now. And I think a large reason for that is, again, Nintendo is really not trying to confirm any games we've heard about in the past with full release dates or announcing new games until they really have a better idea of when for sure those titles are actually going to be able to be widely distributed and brought to people's hands. This is somewhat of the opposite approach of what we're seeing happen right now with a lot of other major companies. For instance, when you look at, say, the launch window of PS5 games for Sony, they've announced a lot of titles for the PS5, but the release dates for them are all over the place and mostly unknowns. They even accidentally leaked some release dates, at least release launch windows, as part of their CES presentation, and promptly removed that information afterwards because they didn't really want people to know that yet. They put a lot of stuff out there, but none of it we really know when it's coming. Now, Nintendo is absolutely guilty of this as well, because at the start of the Switch, we got a lot of games announced that we're still waiting on, with stuff like Metroid Prime 4, Bayonetta 3, even Shin Megami Tensei 5, which we do know is coming out this year, was announced way back in 2017 when the Switch was first being released. And we really didn't hear a peep out of that for years until late last year. I think that's a mistake that Nintendo is not trying to repeat right now, especially with how often people ask about those projects while we're still just kind of getting general announcements of, it's going well, we're working on them. They're trying to avoid that kind of situation for the time being and instead focus on really what they can for sure confirm. And we're going to be seeing that happen, I think, throughout the rest of this year. Not necessarily in the form of directs, but we're going to be seeing a lot more announcements like what happened with Paper Mario, where we're just going to get a brand new game announced out of the blue and see that release date coming in the very impending near future. And if we're lucky and enough stuff gets under control, there might be some kind of bigger back-to-back, big hype presentation that could happen sometime in the summer, getting us ready for that holiday release lineup. But even the possibility of that, I think, right now, is still something that's up in the air.